মাফালে নার এই মাখনে ওকে জিজ্ঞাসা করো নেতা পাল্টি দিয়ে অন্য কিছু মধুবন দিয়ে দিবে সব
Jason Hood.
Yours?
Yashoda Jivan.
Oh, Yashoda Jivan. Yashoda Jivan Prabhu ki.
Jai.
Soul of Yashoda Devi. So, Yashoda Jivan Prabhu ki.
Jai.
Himself Krishna. উদার কে কিছে জন্য উঠাইলে
কাকে
দীক্ষা বালা কে
ওরা কালকে ব্যবস্থা করবে সব
টুমরো
ওই নামেই থাকলো
হ্যাঁ সেম নেম
হু
টেক সেকেন্ড সেকেন্ড ইনিশিয়েশন সেম নেম এন্ড দে শুড বি রেডি এন্ড ইউ শুড টেল देम টু ব্রিং
ঘি এন্ড গ্রেনস
এন্ড ইউ শুড
সো টুমরো দে উইল বি ফায়ার স্যাক্রিফাইস মদন মোহন প্রভু
And the devotees who like to give ahuti in fire sacrifice, they can also come and give ghee in for swaha.
So,
who will manage it for?
Tomorrow morning at 8:30, we would like to have fire sacrifice. So Navin Prabhu is requesting all the devotees to take initiation to bring firewood, ghee, and so many ingredients for the fire sacrifice.
They should come to him and he will, or Subal Sakha Prabhu will advise them to bring something.
Yes.
Anyone should take interest. No. But you should come to Brajnath and you should arrange. Pardon, they will come to you and you.
Oh,
where is the fire sacrifice tomorrow?
House.
Right. There is a house on the road, a cooking center. What are the guys are cooking?
Today, all the articles which are needed, they should be provided today. You should see.
Yes. So after the program, the guys can come to me and those who take initiation, and we will discuss how to obtain all the articles for the fire sacrifice tomorrow.
Radhe Jai Jai Madhavi. Atmosphere should be changed.
Radhe Jaya Jaya Madhava Jai
Long. Radhe Jaya Jaya Madhava Jai Radhe Jaya Jaya Raghunatha Sani Mandala Mahite Radhe Jaya Jaya Namo 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 Namo
Jai Ho Vrindavan Nandana Jai Ho Vrindavan Nandana
So many devotees, they tell that there are so many problems. So many problems coming. I'm not feeling well. Why? Krishna is not making problems. Any other person is not making problems. Only our independent mind, je kotha shune na.
Is not out of control.
Who doesn't hear anything?
The mind.
Disobedient
mind always makes himself so many
problems.
Troubles, so many problems. So always any devotee making so much problems for themselves and not listening Gurudev, obeying Gurudev, then what Gurudev will do? Not like a magic that he will, if anyone wants to drink, but Gurudev has told that you should not drink wine. Oh, this is a very big problem. That I should, I cannot check up my habit. Sometimes it is very problem to follow four basic principles. We know that all these things are very bad things, bad habits. For yourself, your body, your mind, your senses, everything will be poisoned by this. So don't make the problem. Especially nowadays, problem to check lust. We should try to do it. As you are brahmachari or grihastha, ladies or female or male, we should try. That is why a very good method has been invented that you should be married and live equally, giving respect to each other. Not like husband should not think that my wife is like anything to be enjoyed only, like dogs, like cats, like
horse,
like any property. This should be given same respect as you want. And be with her, or she should be with him, not changing for whole life. Otherwise, so many problems will come. If you want to be happy and to chant Krishna name without any problem, then you will have to follow very strictly the Vedic culture. First, we should be Varnashram Dharmi. We should follow Varnashram Dharma, Indian culture. Swamiji has also told, who Swamiji? Bhaktivedanta Swamiji. And all our acharyas have said that we should follow very strictly the rules of Vedic culture and be Varnashrami. Don't disobey. Otherwise, you are creating so many problems. Anyone cannot help. Be so humble and polite to others. If you want to be behaved like that, you should be like that. Otherwise, bhajan will be very, very problem. So if anyhow, any luck, you have come towards bhajan, try to give up all the desires which are opposite to bhakti line, devotion line, and try to take all the things which are helpful. Are ekta ki shabda?
Favorable
for bhakti. And then you see that Krishna is always helping you. Otherwise, he will not help. So, we should not do like this. So, in this case, if anything is coming on problems, so then we should try to hear the pastimes of any good bhakta. Like you heard Prahlad Maharaj. In his life he has no problem any, never. You know, the name of Draupadi, Sri Pandavas, they have so much problem, but they thought that these are not problem. They thought it favorable for bhakti. So they used to create all these things, troubles, to fight with anyone or anything, only that Krishna should always be with him and helping. They were not sufferings for them. Very favorable. So they used to make all these problems that Krishna should always be with me and we will serve him only for this. So they had no any problem. If I am going to love and affect, and serve Krishna, then why we should do all these things? So many luxurious things, so many dogs or hawks or anything, nothing. We should not make problem. Try to love and Krishna in one ended. And there is no problem at all. If you are loving Krishna, and which is favorable for this, we will take all, accept all. Nothing else. Especially for devotees, female or male, those who are initiated second time, second in initiation days. That should be adarsha,
ideal.
In humbleness, like trees, like grasses. Always giving honor to others who deserve these qualities and having no desire to be
glorified, respect.
I don't mind. Then you see that all problems quickly. So we should try to read, to hear the life of any realized Vaishnava. Today Madhavendra Puri, today the birthday of
disappearance,
anything. And also of
Srinivas Acharya.
And also I think that here is Acharya Ratna Prabhu. He is Ratna.
Jewel
of Acharya. So many among all Acharyas. So we should try to learn all these things. I think in this stage in which we are now, it will be more favorable to read and to understand, to hear the pastimes of life sketch of such a devotee, like Haridas Thakur, like Raghunath Das Goswami, like Madhavendra, like Jiva Goswami and others, it will be more beneficial. And don't be derailed from this. If you really want, I think then you should not have any cat in your house. If coming, no harm, but you should not be attached and give your very precious love and affection to that cat or rat. Never to anyone. Prabhu Sanatan Madhavendra Purvi has never had any cow, never a cat or dog,
horse.
So many things. Swamiji has any cat? He had any dog?
Monkeys?
Never. So don't make problems. We should learn something from the life of Madhavendra Puripada. For beginning, and to lost. Always he used to love only whom? Krishna. But to whom Krishna? Whom Krishna? Only beloved of Srimati Radhika. He always knew that Krishna is not my beloved. Krishna is beloved of Srimati Radhika. And I am Kinkari of Srimati Radhika. Always happy in Srimati Radhika happiness and always
unhappy
in and happiness of Srimati Radhika. So when Krishna went to Mathura, there was a big problem for Madhavendra Puri. And what that problem? So you have to recite same slok as Srimati Radhika used to recite, weeping bitterly. And what slok was that? Ai dina dayadrana he Mathura natha kada valokyase hridayam lokat. Oh, what should I do? Where should I go? Radhika is telling. Sakhi, can you tell? Where Shyam Sundar is now? Ai dina dayadrana. Where he has gone, letting me alone here in Vrindavan. I cannot survive. No eating, no drinking, nothing. Always absorbed in Krishna. Sometimes rebuking, weeping but rebuking Krishna. Oh, you have gone to Mathura? Oh, for like you are bee. Oh, there you have been entangled with Kubja. Here, so many beautiful gopis here, leaving them, you have gone to Mathura for Kubja. Oh, Mathuranath. And so Srimati Radhika is so much weeping, so much weeping. Anyone could not pacify her. So Madhavendra Puri, like his Sakhi, he is also weeping in the same line. Ai dina dayadranath he Mathuranath kadavalokyase hridayam tada aloka kataram daita brahmyati kim karo. What should I do now? Always like this. We should try to aim and life of our aim and object of our life, a prem like this, a love and affection for like this. Don't distribute your solid prem, akhanda prem, to anyone in this world. Never. Anything. Not always decorating like this, this same, making up 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, dressing our room so much, so much. To anyone in this world, only whole our prem and love and affection should be given to in the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika or Krishna Yugal, conjugal Krishna. So from beginning, very beginning, you'll have to be very careful. Otherwise, always Maya standing nearby and she will at once attract and our life will be in vain. So don't do. My humble request to all, if you have come to me, you should obey me and try to be like this. You know the history of Madhavendra Puripad? You should tell me. Where is Bhagat Bandha? No, what?
Prabhu.
He's not here?
He's there.
He's in the back.
Where? Where? What is going? What you are doing? Come in. He has come late, perhaps.
No, no, I was here.
Very good. That was going right. Wow.
So Srila Mahananda Puri was a pure devotee of Krishna, and he is said to be the roots of the tree of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because he carried the seed conception of Raja Madhurya Prema, and he appeared before Lord Chaitanya, just as before Krishna appeared, when Lord Brahma went with the devas and the earth personified to the shore of the milk ocean, then Krishna, Shri Lakshmi Vishnu, indicated that Krishna would appear, but before that, his associates would appear to make way for his lila. So similarly with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, some associates appeared before him in order to prepare for his lila. And part of his lila was to taste the confidential moods of Srimati Radhika, and part was also to distribute Braja Prem, and particularly Gopi Manjari Prem. So Madhavendra Puri was sent in advance, and he carried this mood. And then this mood was bestowed upon his disciple Ishvara Puri, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his lila accepted diksha from Ishvara Puri and thus inherited this same mood. Of course, it is coming from him because he is the root of it. So Madhavendra Puri was always absorbed in this state, as Srila Gurudev was saying. He was absorbed in the state of feeling himself as a Manjari maid servant of Srimati Radhika. And in this way, he was wandering here and there. He had a vow that he would never beg alms from anyone. So sometimes he would go for several days without eating. And only if someone approached him and offered him something, then he would accept. Otherwise, he would never request anyone. So one time, he was wandering in Vrindavan, in this state of ecstasy, always remembering Krishna. And also, he always stayed alone because he did not want to come into an association of others and then have to engage in mundane talks. So he would walk absorbed in chanting and remembering Krishna's lila, and forgetting whether it was day or whether it was night or where he was going. So he was wandering in this state in Braj and hadn't eaten for perhaps 2 or 3 days. And then a beautiful young boy came to him, and he brought a pot of milk in a clay pot. And the boy was very immediately attracted his mind. So Madhavendra Puri was astonished because he is not attracted to anything in this world, always absorbed internally in meditating on Krishna. But when he saw this boy completely captivated his mind. And he was wondering, why? Why am I so attracted to this boy? So the boy, he said, my dear sannyasi, I see that you have been fasting, so I brought this pot of milk for you. So he said, how did you know I was fasting? And the boy replied, well, the village women, they have noticed you wandering here and there and not taking anything. And in our village, we don't allow anyone to go hungry. So they have given me this pot of milk and they have requested me to give it to you. So Madhavendra Puri accepted and he drank the milk. And then at the next moment, the boy had disappeared.
and he was not able to find him anywhere. So then he went on chanting and chanting through the night, and then at a certain point he dozed off. Of course, even in sleeping, he's not actually sleeping like us, but always meditating on Krishna and remembering Krishna's
lila. He took
lila.
The milk after the boy went. He took the milk.
Yeah.
And then you have to.
Yeah.
Oh, then go.
So, in the dream, or in his dreams, the same boy came to him again. And then he understood that this boy was Krishna. And in the dream, Krishna said that I have been waiting for you for a long time. Because at that time, the Muslims, they were ruling India. And the Muslims, they attacked many temples and destroyed many of the deities. So the pujaris, they would sometimes, if they got warning that the Muslims were coming, then they would take the deity and they would hide it somewhere in order to protect it. So this pujari, he had hidden the deity of Gopal in the dense forest and then had fled for his life. So this boy Krishna, he came to Madhavendra for his dream, and he said that, I've been waiting a long time for you. I'm hidden in the jungle, and you please rescue me. So when Madhavendra Puri awoke from the dream, then he was actually condemning himself that, oh, this boy came to me. Krishna actually came to me directly, and I could not recognize him. So then he gathered some of the townspeople, or the village people rather, and they took knives and machetes and whatnot, and the forest was very dense, so many weeds and branches. So they cut through the vegetation, and then they found the deity of Gopal. And then for several days performed a installation ceremony for Gopal. So on top of Giriraj Govardhan, on some slab of stone there, they placed the deity, and many Brahmins were called there in order to perform the jagya and the puja. And also, Madhavendra Puri called for foodstuffs to be brought from all the neighboring villages. And so a great quantity of foodstuffs were prepared. And then they were also performing abhishek, bathing the deity, like we did yesterday. So this was going on for several days. But the deity of Gopal had been, for a very long time, had been buried in the earth. And of course, India is very hot, especially in the summertime. So Gopal again appeared to Madhavendra Puri in a dream. And he said that in spite of this abhishek, this bathing going on for several days, still my body is very hot. So you please go to Jagannath Puri and you get sandalwood paste, Malayan chandan there, the very famous sandalwood. So this is a very long way from Vrindavan, and at that time there was no planes or trains or anything like that. So Madhavendra Puri, he went everywhere on foot. So it was a very long journey, and there were many obstacles to face because the Muslims were ruling at the time, and there were so many different like border crossings and whatnot. So Madhavendra Puri took up this journey, and when he got to Remuna, which is not so far from Puri, there's one deity of Gopinath there. And this deity is a very famous deity, and they used to offer kheer to this deity. And this kheer was renowned all over. So Madhavendra Puri, he was thinking that if we can offer this type of kheer to Gopal, it will be very nice. So when he was thinking like that, it was as if he was desiring to sample the kheer in order to be able to prepare it in the same way. But at the same moment, he chastised himself because he considered that, oh, I am desiring to taste the kheer of Gopinath before it is even offered to him. So this is very sinful. So now I will have to fast. And he gave up his idea to taste the kheer. And he just simply went in the village and was chanting. But at the night, Gopinath appeared in a dream to the pujari and said that I have hidden a pot of kheer. They offer kheer to the deity. And he said, you did not notice, but I have hidden one pot underneath my cloth. So you should go and find it there. And then after that, you should find this sannyasi, this devotee, Madhavendra Puri, and you should give it to him. So the pujari got up, washed himself, put on fresh cloth, and then went on the altar, and indeed, underneath the cloth of Gopinath was a pot of this sweet rice. So thereafter, this Gopinath became known as Kirchor Gopinath. Gopinath who stole, or the thief Gopinath, who stole sweet rice for his devotee, Madhavendra Puri. So the pujari went out afterward, hauling all over, and finally he found Madhavendra Puri. And then he gave him this sweet rice, and he said that Gopinath has stolen this for you. You are so fortunate, you are so beloved to the Lord. So Madhavendra Puri was appreciating the mercy of the Lord, the mercy of his dear Lord. Yet at the same time, he was thinking that by the morning time, this story will be spread all over. And then so much praise will come because people will be saying, oh, what a great devotee this person must be that Gopinath has stolen kheer for him. So he left that place immediately, not wanting to be praised. And he carried on with his journey. And then finally he arrived in Puri and he got the chandan and also some camphor to mix with it. And it was very heavy. So he got two other persons to help in carrying this. Yet still they were having to do this whole journey on foot and carry it on their backs. Something like 80 kilos, I think. So, as he was making his way back to Vrindavan, then Gopal again appeared to him in a dream for the third time. And he said that if you simply go to Ramuna again, to Gopinath, I am not different from Gopinath, or Gopinath is not different from I. So, if you go there and you prepare this sandalwood for Gopinath, then I will be completely satisfied. It will be the same as if you apply it on me. So, Madhavendra Puri did this. He returned to Ramuna, and of course there, he could not escape the fame which was coming to him, being such a great devotee of the Lord. But the Lord also did this to show the glory of Madhavendra Puri, and also to relieve him from having to return all the way to Braj with the chandan, and also to show that he is non-different. All his forms are identical to him. So I'll stop there.
You know that Madhavendra Puri was disciple of any sannyasi of Madhvacharya Sampradaya. Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. Nityananda Prabhu was also disciple of the same Lakshmi Pati Tirtha. As Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was initiated by Ishwar Puripad. And he took sannyas from Keshav Bharati in Kantapur Nagar. In the same way, Madhavendra Puri was originally disciple of Lakshmipati Tirtha. And after that, when Lakshmipati Tirtha passed away from this world, he wanted to take renounce order. But his Gurudev was not there. So he took sannyas from anyone of Madhvacharya line, and his name was Sampuri. Vishnupuri. And he became sannyasi. Understand? So he was Madhavendra Puri. If anyone can have an argument, a doubt that if he was in Madhvacharya Sampradaya, they are all called Tirtha. But how he became Puri? Oh, also in Madhvacharya line, some Tirth and some Puri also. So he took initiation first from Lakshmi Tirth, and after he passed away, he took renounce order from Vishnu Puri. He was also a very learned person and very high class, from whom he took initiation Lakshmipati Tirtha. They were in line of Madhvacharya, and they were devotees of Bal Gopal. Bal Gopal, you know?
Taking a churning stick, holding churning stick.
Yes. And also in the same time, they used to worship Narayan as that. Lakshmi Narayan. Actually, they were worshipper of Lakshmi Narayan, but they used to worship Bal Gopal. They're all established thoughts are like that. Narayan. But this Puri, in the same line, he was in the line of Gopi's mood, Vishnu Puri. And he has written some books, very good books, about this, in the line of Gopi Prem. So he was not Tattvavadi. Who? Madhavendra Puri. But he was as a Gopi mood devotee, pure devotee. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took initiation, one of the disciples of Madhavendra Puri. That is, he was Ishwar Puri. In his last career, we see that he was always weeping. Oh, Krishna, very happy. Always observing this. Always weeping, crying bitterly so much. He Deva, He Daita, He Bhuvanaika Bandho, He Krishna, He Chapala, He Karunaika Sindho, He Nath, He Ramana, He Nayana Abhiram, Ha ha kadan bhavita. Like Srimati Radhika, these two slokas of Radhika. But in the middle time, there was none who can recite these slokas. And in the same mood like Radhika. After long time, Madhavendra Puri became like this, like Braja Prem. And Gopi. He Deva means you are worshipable. You are so beautiful. I cannot forget you. Though you can forget us, and you have gone to Mathura, and you have so many beloved there. We are Gwalini one. Gwalini, you know, Gopi. We are not so much beautiful as Mathura.
Jadavas.
The wives of Jadavas. We are not so much beautiful now. We are not so much. We have no so much quality like them. But we cannot live without you. We will die about you. So he, they, that means
beloved.
You are my beloved. But why you left us and went? Why? If you are calling us to Vrindavan, I cannot go there. We cannot go there. Why? Oh, you have so many beloved there. What is the use of our going?
In Mathura.
There your father, mother and all are there. And you are so happy with them. We don't want to. But you are our Dait. So much beloved. He Deva, He Dait, He Bhuvanekabandha. Then, oh, I've told wrong. You are Mathurana. Hey Mathurana. Oh, now you are the emperor of Mathura kingdom. You have left Vrindavan. Because you used to go to cowherds without umbrella, without any shoe, nothing. Without affluence where? But now you have become Mathuranath. So how you will remember us? Very simple gopis. Not qualified at all. We cannot make garland like the omens of Mathura, the Kesoris of Mathura. They can do so much. They can serve you well, Mathuranath. When you will return? Will you return? And some Krishna is thinking that, oh, Krishna has come. And making like this. Understand?
Covering our eyes.
Oh, who are you? Who are you? Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra. No. And at once, oh, you Krishna? So when you will come like this? Kadava Lokasi. Hridayam,
okay?
Itana. He Nath, He Raman, He Nainath, Hina, Ha Ha, Kodan, Ha Han.
He Deva, Deide, Kurnai Kasindha, He Krishna, He Chapala, He Kurnai Kasindha, Ha Nath, He Ramana, He Ramana, Yanaviram.
So, beautiful meaning of this is Lord. And always remembering and always waiting. Once his one disciple came there. You know that Ishwarpuri Pavad serving always with same mood as he was. Always serving in all ways. Giving Nahaprasadam, making him bath, serving him in all respect. But another Shishya was also disciple, Ramchandrapuri.
Ramchandrapuri.
He came there and he told to him that why are you very uselessly? Eridon's order, sannyasi should not be. He should think that I am Brahma. I am Nirvishesh Brahma. No love and affection for anyone, even for his body, nothing. He should be renounced. So why you are weeping? Then at once Madhavendra Puripad told his old disciples, take him and get him out of my
assembly,
bhajan kuti. I don't want to see his face again in my life. And he was driven out. And he gave all modes to Ishwar Puripad. You have heard that how he was renounced, that he never begged anything to anyone. He knew that Krishna will arrange everything. When Krishna took some milk in a pot and went to Govardhan, where his mother and Puri was always observed weeping, rolling down on the earth. And he gave, "Oh, my mother has seen you. You have not taken anything for 4 or 5 days. And you are hungry." But he don't beg to anyone. "So my mother has sent me to give this milk to you. You should take it, and I'm going
to later I shall come and take it back.
And again I will come and will take return this pot." Madhavendra Puri.
"I can delay, my mother will give it to me."
Madhavendra Puri was hearing, but giving no importance. But his sweet words and standing God in threefold attracted him. And said, "Who is this boy? In my whole life, anyone, any boy, any girl, any wife, any woman, any person had not shown me in whole world. In my whole life. But how he charmed me? In what a position, in a mood he is standing threefold. How beautiful, though he is black, but how beautiful.
Village boy.
And how sweet words. I've never heard any sweet word like this." And he was doing like this. His
eyebrow.
Eyelid. Eyelids were not
going down.
Always. And that boy turned in at once. "Oh, he may know me. So quickly, oh, my mother will rebuke me, so I'm just going, I'm returning." And he did in such a mood that Madhavendra Puri took him in his heart. After that, boy went and he was watching, chanting, but now no interest in chanting, only looking at
that boy.
Who was that boy? Who was that boy? Who was that boy? He went. The boy went and he was watching the way, path. It so much time went, but he was always remembering that. Who was he? He was. In the meantime, he sleepiness, semblance of, kya kahte hain?
Snooze.
Semblance of sleep came, what?
Semblance of
not so deep.
Drowsiness.
Dozing.
And he saw in a dream, very beautiful, same boy. And what he is narrating. From this Madhavendra Puri, Ishwar Puri Path came. Not only Ishwar Puri Path, the roots of Bhakti. Bhakti Madhavendra Puri is the whole tree. And not whole tree.
The sprout.
Roots.
And three, nine roots were Paramananda Puri, Ishwar Puri, Brahmananda, and so many.
Nine.
Advaita Charya also was disciple of same.
Madhavendra Puri.
Also, Bakreshwar Pandit, what? The guru of Gadadhar Pandit.
Pundarik
Vidyanidhi. All were in this line. Not only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not luckily Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Ishwar Puri Path. All knowingly they went in this line. So this line is genuine. Now some are doubting. They are the messenger of Kali.
Spy of Kali. Spy, Guptachar.
Guptachar. A spy of Kali. You should not trust them. So we should like to be a devotee like Madhavendra. Today is also disappearance day of
appearance.
Appearance day of
Srinivasacharya.
Who was he? Srinivasacharya.
Disciple of Gopal Bhatta.
He was disciple of Gopal Bhatta. He was in a very extricated Brahmin family. And for bringing childhood, he was so learned person in Sanskrit and Bengal. Very. And he was so honest and good character person. He first went to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Gadadhar Pandit in Navadvip. And when he started from his village, native place, when he came nearer to Navadvip, he heard that Mahaprabhu has left this world. Right. And all his Advaita Acharya, everything has been left. Then he became so upset. He started to go for
Jagannathpuri.
I will meet Gadadhar Pandit. I will meet Sarup Damodar, Raghunath Das, and all others. Sikhi Maiti, Madhavi Devi, Maharaj Pratap Rudra, Sarvam Bhattacharya. Very eagerly he was going. But when he was in the way, he heard that Gadadhar Prabhu had disappeared in the Munkeshok Mahaprabhu.
Separation of Mahaprabhu.
Of separation of Mahaprabhu. Gadadhar Pandit. And he has entered in the deity of
Gopinath.
He heard that Sarup Damodar has uploaded. He heard that Raghunath Das Goswami has gone to from Jagannath Puri to Vrindavan only to die. He will go there and he will jump in Jamuna, or he will go to Govardhan and from there jump. And thus he will die. But he could not. Rupsanatan saved him and he began to live in
Radhapur
and bring so much high class of bhajan there, you know. Rupa Raghunath Pade Rahu Muras Prarthanaya Kare Sada Narottam Das Krishna Rupa Raghunath
Narottam Das
Rupa Raghunath
Pade Hoi Vyakuti
Nare Krishna Das
Daya Koroshi Acharya Kamushinivas.
So say Srivasa Acharya Prabhu, after that he returned and he came to Vrindavan and he was so much upset what to do. Mahaprabhu and all his followers happened. Anyway, when he came to Prayag, he heard that Rupa and Sanatan both has left this world. Now he was weeping so much loudly. Anyhow, he met Vrindavan and he met with Jiva Goswami. And Jiva Goswami kindly kept him with him and began to give his association and all teaching all Shastra to him. In the meantime, Narottam Thakur and Shyamanand also went to Vrindavan. And all were in the school of Jiva Goswami. After that, when they were so much matured in all kinds of Shastra, Jiva Goswami told that, I want to give you all the books of Rupa and Sanatan and of myself and all other books. And you should take it in a bullock cart and go to
Bengal
and preach all over Bengal. Because now Bengal has become devotee-less. You should preach there very strongly. So, all the books of Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Ujjal Nilmani, Bhakti Goswami, Sindhu and all books, and the all books compiled by Jiva Goswami, Chaitanya Charitamrita, all the books were given in the cart. And 2-3 protectors, guards, boys, and 3 boys, who? Narottam Thakur, Shyamanand and Srinivas was more elder than both. And they used to serve him and to obey Srinivas Acharya. In the meantime, when the cart was nearer to Bengal, in a very dense forest, some dacoits came and their astrologer told that they have a very precious jewels in the cart. And then the king of the dacoits,
Hambi,
was a very dangerous dacoit. He at once followed with his
followers.
And anyhow, when they were sleeping, anyhow taking rest because they are all tired, in the meantime, quickly they took away, stolen the
cart.
And when they went there and saw that what is there, only books. Oh, these are papers, not of any use, bogus things. But they kept the cart there. In the meantime, when they spoke and they saw that, where is cart? And they were doing like this. What?
Hitting their head by the hand.
And weeping so much. Srinivas told that, yes, so they returned to Bengal and I am here searching, and after taking books, I will return. Otherwise, no. So Shyamananda Prabhu and Narottam Thakur went there and they gave some letter to Jiva Goswami and others that books have been stolen. But in the meantime, Srinivas was searching here and there like a beggar boy. One day he went in the council of king, that is
Birhambir,
the commander-chief of all the dacoits. And he saw that in his council, some priest, Brahmin, was reading Srimad Bhagavata and explaining. It seems that this king is very religious and pious, and he has some bhakti with Krishna. So I should anyhow mix with this, and I should please him, and then I will search. When the Harikatha explanation of Bhagavat was
finished.
Srinivas, as a boy of only 18 years, and he stood up and told to king, "O king, I want to explain the same slokes which he has explained. I think he had not explained well." And then he began to explain. King told that, "I want to hear your explanations." And all were so learned. So he began to. What? Madhupakitava bandho mastri sangri shapatna. And he explained in such a way this separation mode of Radhika and Gopis and Krishna. Himself he was early, and all so bitterly, and all the counselors began to be. And quickly time passed. After 3-4 hours, when he finished one slok, and then king himself with his all counselors went in and fell flat on the lotus feet of Srinivasa Acharya. Oh, how beautiful it is. We want that you should initiate us. We are all searching of a very pure, bona fide, qualified guru. I see that in the whole world. I cannot have a guru like you. You are bona fide. I have never seen a person like you, so qualified. He told that, "I can, but you'll have to give some dakshina to me, otherwise not."
This is the rule also, without dakshina.
If you are taking harinam or diksha and initiation and not giving something, donation, not donation, but dakshina to Gurudev, Diksha will not be successful. Initiation will, Guru will not never want anything. But we should do. Shorten. If you are brahmachari, you cannot give, then you should give yourself, your body, mind, soul, everything. And if you grihastha, you should give anything. What is? And which will be useful for my Gurudev? They should give. So, he told, the king answered that I know this thing. I will give you anything you like. Then he told, I have lost
a
full of
a cart full of books.
Books.
A cart full of
and very useful, like more than jewels valuable. So if you can give me this donation, then I can. King began to smile. Oh, how he knew that these books are with me and how can help? And he again fell flat on the lotus feet. Just now I am giving you. Before initiation and after initiation, I will give myself, my kingdom, my whole family, everything forever. And then at once he ordered that bullock cart should be
brought
here with as it was, full of books. Oh, when books were brought, Srinivas Pandit fell flat and doing pranam to all books, like if they are Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Krishna, and all others. There was the explanation of Sanatana Goswami, Vaishnava Toshini of Bhagavatam, Jiva Goswami,
Lagu
Vaishnava Toshini, and all the books of Srila Rupa Goswami, Ujjwal Nilmani, Bhaktriya Swami Sindhu, all the books of Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. Sandarbha, all these Sar Sandarbha were there, Sar Sambhadri and all so beautiful. Gopal Champu, all. And he became so melted. He told that you have given me life. Then he initiated. Not only him, his wife,
all
his children, and his
all ministers,
associates, counselors. And king gave his heart, mind, soul, and everything to him. I am your eternal service. And he never disobeyed in his whole life. We see in these days that you have initiated anyone and he will give you everything, and next day he will go to another guru, Sahajiya guru, or any other guru, Brahmavadi guru, here, there. And he will, if Gurudev will tell, oh, kindly come to me, I will not come. So, now it is a very big problem, and that is why we are not having Krishna prema. No bhakti, pure bhakti. So, we should try to follow Srinivasacharya. And then he took all the cards and went to Bengal, nearer to Katwa, and then Shyamananda and Narottam Thakur were also called, and so many were called, and in our whole Bengal, even to Assam, and everywhere, Manipur, Bhaktivat priest, he was so a scholar. Then he used to explain Srimad Bhagavatam, weeping, and Krishna with his all beloved gopis, they used to come and to give darshan. And he was a very beautiful kirtaniya, and he has so many rag and ragini.
Melodies. Different melodies.
Melody. And he used to play on mridanga, as if he will quickly jump.
Also
Srimasacharya. They have some
Ragini Manohar Sahi.
Manohar Sahi.
Narottam Thakur Garanhati.
Garanhati. Manohar Sahi. So many beautiful ragini. Ragini, you know that?
Melody.
Classic.
Oh, good. Sare ga ma pa dha ni sa. And then sha ni dha pa ma ga re sha. Very beautiful melody. When Krishna used to sing in Pancham, in five.
Fifth time.
Then Gopi followed and they seven. Used to sing in?
Seven.
Seven. And Krishna had no tune there.
Sadhu, sadhu,
sadhu. And then Krishna used to tell, oh, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. I cannot do like you. So said, his one of the daughter was named Hemlata Thakurani. He became preacher, very famous preacher. He was perhaps married to anyone. And she was very famous preacher. So many disciples she made. And thus she was famous. He was married, Sri Mahaspandi.
Yeah.
But even Ramananda was also married. But Narottam Thakur was not married. But all used to give the same respect to three. And when they used to meet together, like bosom brother, like what?
Bosom friend.
Embrace each other.
We should try to follow them and to be devotee like them. If you are falling, only 1% even, it is enough for us. So you should be a strong follower of all this. I have come here only to sprinkle their mercies to you. You should not disobey. Never doubt anything in bhakti. Only you want to, you should try to give your akhanda prem, akhanda love.
Your whole love.
Undivided love.
Only to Krishna and devotees, not to anyone. Don't, what?
Divide your love.
To any fraction. Then you will be a pure devotee. Gaur Brahma. Today will be some play.
Tomorrow will be play.
Not today. They are not ready. Then any kirtan?
Some name. Announce they have come.
They have come. One family who was not there in the beginning. They have arrived.
After, you should announce their name.
Andrew. Andrew Wainwright, please stand up. Abhinandan.
Abhinandan?
Yes.
Abhinandan Das Prabhu. He was a good.
His wife, Anna Marie.
Yes, over there.
Aditi.
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 Daniel Gidge,
Aditi. You can have.
Aditi.
Stand up.
Who?
Oh, yes,
Aditi. Oh, sorry, Aditi. Third point. After what I mean?
Daniel Gidge,
who is?
Yeah.
Oh? Gauranga Nandesh.
Huh?
Gauranga.
Oh, Gauranga Sundar. Gauranga Sundar Prabhu. Yeah.
Anybody else who have not received their name, please raise their hand.
There are other children also.
Very. What kind of
question?
Who?
You can do Jajara Dharman Haribo. Achai, you should do. But you should do Gauranga Bolita Hale. Then that.
Gauranga Bolita Hale.
Gauranga Balite Hare
Pulaka Shri Hare 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 Hari 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 Hari
Let's go. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,